What is your big takeaway from these bypolls, not just Kairana, but when you look at the whole picture?
Well, I think one message is loud and clear, that if the opposition unites, which they hadn't all this time, then I think BJP has a really serious fight on its hands for 2019. 2019 was being taken as a kind of a no contest, that Mr. Modi ji was supposed to be sweeping
it. Walk over.
Even Nitish Kumar some time ago said there is no contest in 2019. Mr. Omar Abdullah said that think of 2024, don't think of 2019. So from that position, I think what today's results show, that if the opposition unites, comes together anywhere, they can defeat the BJP. We saw that even without uniting in Karnataka, BJP had a setback. But today's setback is serious, and BJP needs to introspect a lot as to how they are going to change track or reinvent themselves to kind of get the upper hand again.
Is there a course correction needed?
Well, you see, the issue of Ganna in particular, I would say that the BJP did not pay adequate attention to it. Ganna farmers are very unhappy, as you know, and it was palpable. Everybody was there for everybody to see. So I think BJP leaders will hope that Mr. Modi can do some course correction and again recreate that magic that you were talking about, which I don't think is impossible. Mr. Modi is a very canny politician. He understands the pulse of the people, and some mistakes that have happened, like this one paisa cut in petrol price, for instance, which is a cruel joke, was rightly panned by everybody. Now, these kind of mistakes must be avoided.
What are the other mistakes?
No, there have been
since you're listing
things,
them.
The farmers' distress, issue of farmers, Ganna farmers. Well, I think BJP has to be much more proactive in resolving this, because Mr. Modi has tried to emphasize again and again, BJP is not a party of the rich, it's not Soot Boot Ki Sarkar, it is a party of the poor and the farmers. He emphasizes this again and again. Now, some of this must come out into action.